A simple interaction that has become the point of losing a teacher's life. How could she ever be in the hands of the suspect? And how she reached her last unfortunate destination? And how a criminal is able to hide for almost half a year from police? Before we begin, if you are new to our channel, hit that subscribe button and click that notification bell to get more contents like this. Lindsay Ann Hodger was born on December 30, 1984 from a small village in the country of England. Her friends and relatives recognized her as a smart, kind, beautiful and adventurous woman. She was attending King Henry School until she finished senior high school. After that she continued her studies at the University of Guilds in the biology course, and she completed it and was with the honors students in 2006. Although she wanted to continue her master's degree, she first thought of traveling abroad and teaching English language for making money, while she was waiting for her class for her master's degree. Lindsay therefore saw the opportunity to move to Japan, to become an English teacher she fulfilled in October 2006. When she arrived in Japan, she lived in an apartment in the Shiba city, where she had cheaper rent, including two female foreigners who were also teachers. However, was a bit homesick, because she was the first time away from her family, Lindsay insisted she could talk to her family via email and Skype. She often entertained himself by touring the sites near her apartment on her bike. 6 months later Lindsay gradually became accustomed to life in Japan, her interaction with her students, and living in her apartment with two co-teachers. One day, coming home from her job, as she was taking her bike out of Shiba Station, a man came up to him. She noticed the man was approaching, but she didn't notice it but he just bought the lock on her bike. But as he was busy, the man suddenly spoke, "You are my English teacher." Lindsay wondered what the man said. She was sure that during her 6 months of teaching in Tokyo she had never seen this man in her class. Lindsay smiled at the man and said she might have made a mistake, because she didn't this known or seen in her class even when. After that she got on her bike and was still on her way to the train station, but she noticed that the man was still accompanying him. Out of fear she was pumping her bike pace, the speed of the man's step changed, too, until she was pursued. While running, the man tries to get to know Lindsay by asking personal things. Lindsay insisted on ignoring the man and turned her attention to the babies, but because of the many pangs in the alley at Shiba she was unable to mislead the man. He stopped opposite way from her apartment following the man also stopped chasing him. Here the man spoke to him again, asking if he could be Lindsay's tutor in English. Because of Lindsay's fear, she immediately denied the man's offer to her. Still there her schedule was full so she couldn't handle the extra work. It was obvious to the man that she was not happy, because she didn't seem to get her answer from Lindsay. When Lindsay pulled her parking bike across her apartment she suddenly spoke to the man again, asking for water to drink because it was too tired to run. Although Lindsay hesitated to request a small man's request. Lindsay also grew up remembering that there were two more people in her apartment so if something was going to make the man bad she couldn't do it. When they entered, Lindsay reached a glass of water for the man. Here the man again offered Lindsay to be her tutor, but this time she raised an offer $32 per session, the man's last offer to Lindsay. If this offer an easy money came to her. Lindsay agreed to the talk and she set up their first session at a nearby coffee shop. The man was thrilled and later introduced it as Tetsuya Chihashi, 28 years old man and was born into a wealthy family. Both Tetsuya's parents have a background in the field of medicine. Her father was a doctor in the local Shiba hospital, while her mother was a dentist. Tetsuya is known as a loner at their school. When she graduated from Shiba University in 2005, she never sought a job in Bangkok and lived up to her parents' support. For $920 every month he lived alone in Shiba town. After Tetsuya returned the glass to Lindsay, it demanded paper and ball pen. Lindsay watched every move of the ball pen on Tetsuya's paper before it was recalled and returned to her paper. Inside the paper was a sketch of Lindsay's face next to Tetsuya's number and name of Chihashi. A few days later the day of the first session of Chihashi and Lindsay, It was March 24, 2007, as it was about to take place. Two met at the nearest coffee shop. Lindsay taught at Chihashi well. And when it was over, their session at Chihashi was fortunate that she would pay what they ate at the coffee shop, but when the Chihashi had his pocket, not his wallet, she was ashamed that she had told Lindsay his situation. He said he could take his wallet to his apartment, because it was close to the coffee shop, and if Lindsay wanted it would have gone so far as to fly her back to the train station. Lindsay agreed and they took a taxi to Chihashi's apartment. When they got to the apartment, Lindsay first let Chihashi get inside before he talked to the taxi driver. Lindsay told the taxi driver she would just take a moment and if she could wait for him to go straight to the train station after a transaction with Chihashi's apartment. The driver agreed and said he would just wait for the building to open. Lindsay's entry into Chihashi's apartment met him with a loud headshot. Lindsay dropped by the force of Chihashi's scourge and tried to crawl out of the apartment and ask for help, but before he could do it, Chihashi pulled her hair out and dragged him into a room where he had done so badly and Chihashi had killed him with a pillow cover on her face. After Chihashi was cleared, he quickly room. She was looking for a way to hide Lindsay's body and answered it when she saw her detachable bathtub. He released it to the balcony of his apartment and there he put Lindsay's body. He fitted it with soil and plants to hide the girl's body. Days later, Lindsay's two friends would report to the police because it did not come to her job and did not return to their apartment. According to an interview with Lindsay's two friends, Chihashi became their main suspect because he was the last they saw with Lindsay before losing their friend. Police immediately went to Chihashi at his apartment to investigate. 9 policemen knocked on Chihashi's door. They opened the door to trace the panic on Chihashi's face, suddenly running fast, but the police tried to stop him and escaped. The suspect escaped that police had beaten Chihashi's apartment, and there they found Lindsay's body armed in a bathtub full of land and plants. The police also suffered some bruises and wounds to the girl's body in noticing. Attention is bald head. In the room, Chihashi found different colors of the wig and the police thought, one of which was Lindsay's own hair. Police spread Chihashi's picture all over Tokyo, but not a single report came to them. On the other hand, a year after he fled, Chihashi moved to Osaka, where he works as a construction worker. His income he accumulates to be paired with his face. This way he was not easily found by the police, but before he was fired, he had already tried to change his form. The lower lip was scooped, and the nose parted to change its shape. As Tokyo police figured out how to catch Chihashi, they raised the reward from 1 million yen and it became 10 million yen. Police also circulated information to people whose suspects may have been retracted so they should be baptized. And in 2009, police received a call from a plastic surgeon in Nagoya. Here Dr. Chihashi said one of his patients. He saw Chihashi's wanted poster and compared it to the before and after result of surgery. Police later circulated Chihashi's new photo. And an Chihashi co-worker approached the police and confirmed Chihashi's possible whereabouts. Chihashi quickly set fire to Okinawa. But before he was found by the ship, he was looking for an employee and immediately alerting the security. Police quickly went and arrested Chihashi. He was arrested in the rape case and murder. And after 8 months of trial, Lindsay's family achieved justice. On July 21, 2011, he was released by life imprisonment. Justice was given properly and justly. After the jail was published, a book in which Chihashi recounted how he had been hiding for 2.5 years from the police and had a 100,000 copy. The proceeds from the books will be given to Lindsay's family in return for Chihashi's guilt, but Lindsay's parents did not accept it because their child's life could not be